Jake here for American Trucks, and today I'm taking a look at the Rough Country 3.5-inch bolt-on suspension lift kit with the lifted M3 struts and V2 monotube shocks, fitting 2019 and newer Ram 1500s without air ride, excluding the TRX models. If you're looking for a comprehensive way to get more height for off-roading or larger wheels and tires at a more budget-friendly price, you're gonna wanna check out this kit from Rough Country. This is a bolt-on all-inclusive lift kit that's gonna get you 3.5 inches of extra height and also level out the stance of your truck while maintaining stock ride quality and allowing you to keep overall suspension geometry that is very similar to stock. Now this again is a 3.5-inch lift, so it's going to provide you with enough clearance to run some larger wheels and tires on your truck too. Now Rough Country says that you can fit up to 33-inch tires without any clearance issues, and they do fit quite well as you can see here on our truck. Now any larger than that, or if you have a really wide wheel or one with an aggressive offset, then just be mindful that you may have to do some trimming. Now to achieve that lift up front, you get a set of Rough Country's heavy duty upper control arms. Now these are forged aluminum arms and they include new Clevite rubber bushings. So they're gonna provide excellent absorption of road impacts. They're pretty lightweight too, but they still have a lot of structural integrity, definitely enough to hold up to whatever abuse you might be able to throw at them. Now you might have noticed too that the ball joints that are already included are also angled to accommodate for that lift. So despite adding quite a bit of height, these are gonna keep things pretty much the same as your factory suspension geometry, which means that the truck is gonna maintain its factory ride quality. You're gonna get a full range of motion out of this, so that means you can take advantage of that added ride height. Now up front, you also get a set of Rough Country's M3 premium struts. These are gonna combine with those control arms to give you that 3.5 inches of lift up front. Now obviously these come pre-assembled, so there's no need to mess with spring compressors or anything like that. You can just bolt these right in place of your original struts. These are also designed specifically for lifted applications, since they are larger in total height than your stock struts too. That's really important. So that damping is tuned to keep the ride smooth out on the road, while still doing a good job of absorbing impacts and controlling rebound out on the trail. So that nitrogen charging also helps with heat dissipation. So even under aggressive off-roading conditions, if you're hitting a bunch of successive bumps, the shocks aren't gonna suffer from fade. So that means you can use them to their full extent without having to worry about them fading or losing control of the truck. Now in the rear, we've got a couple of things as well. We have these heavy duty coil spring spacers that are gonna lift up the springs, but also help maintain that stock geometry. Now the spacers themselves measure just about 2 inches. So that is gonna add up to about a 2-inch total lift in the rear, and that's gonna level out the truck's stance. So you get the 3.5 inches up front, 2 in the rear, truck's gonna sit pretty much level. You also get a set of Rough Country's V2 monotube shocks, and that's gonna help keep everything in check, and again, maintain that really nice ride quality. Like the fronts, these are also nitrogen charged, but they utilize a floating piston design. It's gonna keep the nitrogen and that shock oil separate. So this means that they respond really fast, but they won't suffer from cavitation or bubbles popping up in the fluids. So you're gonna get a smoother ride, really fast heat dissipation, and solid damping performance as well out on the trail or on the street. Now, since these are a monotube design, there is no external reservoir. So while they may not be quite Baja ready, they are still pretty strong. And the coolest part is that they mount inverted. So where most shocks are gonna mount with the body towards the ground, these are gonna mount with the piston facing down and the body of the shock closer to the truck itself. Having inverted shocks is great for impact resistance because they add strength against the lateral forces. So when you're out there hitting the bumps, these aren't gonna move around as much as a conventional shock with the piston towards the top. That big shock body helps keep everything aligned, so it's just by nature larger than the piston, so it's gonna do a good job of absorbing those impacts. Plus, the hardcore off-road racers tend to run inverted shocks on their rigs, and who wouldn't want a little bit of that connection on their own truck, right? Construction here is all quite solid. As I mentioned, the control arms up front are made from forged aluminum for strength and weight savings. No seams or welds to break on these, so you can be sure that they're strong. The front struts have a massive 1 3/8-inch bore and a hardened chrome piston rod, so they're also gonna stand up to the elements quite well too. The bodies are finished in a silver powder coat for good looks and durability. Now at back, the rear shocks feature a 46 millimeter piston and T6061 aluminum bodies. And the spacers are made from a heavy duty composite type of material, and they're black to help keep them inconspicuous and protect them from the elements. Pricing for this kit comes in at about $1,400 for everything you're seeing here, plus the hardware that's included in the boxes. Now, there are some less expensive options out there, but they're not gonna have all the features like the shocks, the control arms, the spacers, etc. You could also, of course, spend a lot more on a different kit, but for a truck that's gonna see mixed street and trail usage, this is an excellent option that can be made to fit into your build's budget. Like most lift kits, installation here is going to get a 3 out of 3 and will likely take you about 6 hours to complete, possibly a little bit more. Now, you can do this at home in your driveway, especially since everything you need to get it done is included. Like I mentioned, you get all new hardware and bushings for the shocks as well. But it is a bit of an involved job. If you aren't necessarily comfortable disassembling suspension components, then professional install is always an option. But you can definitely do this at home, and there are no modifications needed to your truck. Just bolt all this stuff on and hit the road. Just make sure you get your truck aligned once you've got everything buttoned up and given it a couple days to settle. But with that, let's head over to the install bay where we'll show you how to get this installed on your truck.
Tools required for this install include a couple different size impact guns, a clip remover tool, a pair of flush cutters, 14, 22, and 15 16th wrench, 15, 18, and 21 millimeter ratcheting wrench, a hammer, a hook, 8, 14, 16, and 21 millimeter sockets, 13, 16, and 21 millimeter swivel sockets, a ratchet, a pry bar, and pole jacks or jack stands. What's up, guys? Today we're installing a lift kit on our Ram, so let's get started. So our first step is to remove a 13 millimeter bolt holding our brake line in to get a little more slack on that, as well as pop our ABS line out of some clips. So we can grab our 13 millimeter socket to remove this bolt holding our brake line in place. And then we can grab a clip remover tool to pop out the clip in our upper control arm, holding our ABS line in place. And then we can pop our ABS line out of the clip that's attached to our brake line. Now on the back side of our knuckle, we have this S clip that has a grommet on our ABS line that we can pop out of place. Next, we can disconnect our tie rod end. We have a 21 millimeter nut that we can take a 21 millimeter socket to loosen up. Now, once we have our nut loosened up, we can take a hammer and smack the side of the knuckle to pop our ball joint free. And then we can thread the rest of our nut off and throw it back on so that we don't lose it. Next, if we come to the bottom side of our lower control arm, we have an 18 millimeter nut holding our sway bar end link into place. So we'll grab an 18 millimeter socket to take that off. Now you're gonna wanna do that same thing on the other side to make it easy to pop your sway bar out of place. Now with our sway bar end link unbolted on both sides, we can grab a pry bar to get our sway bar end links out of our lower control arms. Next, we can disconnect our upper control arm ball joint. So I've got a 21 millimeter ratcheting wrench to loosen up our nut, and then we'll do the same thing as the tie rod and hit it with a hammer. And then once we have that loose, we'll give the knuckle a couple smacks with a hammer to pop our ball joint free. And then we can pull down on our upper control arm and loosen up our nut. Next, we can loosen up our lower strut bolt. I have a 15/16 wrench for our nut side and a 21 millimeter socket for our nut side to loosen this up. And to get the bolt the rest of the way out, I'm just gonna grab a wrench on the flat side of the bolt and pull backwards while loosening it up with a 21 millimeter socket. Next, we can remove the 3 nuts at the top of our strut. Now, I like to start with the back since they're a little harder to get to. And once you get them loose, you can just spin them the rest of the way off. I'm using a 16 millimeter ratcheting wrench to remove these nuts. So now we're ready to remove our strut. So you're gonna wanna grab a buddy to grab a pry bar and pry down on the lower control arm so we can get the bottom strut mount over the lower control arm. Next, we can remove our upper control arm. We have a 21 millimeter bolt on each side holding this in. I've got a hook on our knuckle holding it up just so that we don't put any tension on the axle or the brake lines. So we'll grab a 21 millimeter socket, get it behind our fender liner, and remove our bolts. Now moving on to the rear, the first thing we're gonna do is remove our fender liner. We have 4 8-millimeter screws that will take an 8-millimeter socket to remove. Next, we can disconnect our sway bar end link from the frame. We have a 16 millimeter bolt, so I'll grab a 16 millimeter socket to remove that. You're gonna wanna make sure that your axle is supported on jack stands once you start disconnecting this. Next, we can disconnect our track bar from our driver's side. We have a 21 millimeter bolt that will take a 21 millimeter socket to remove. Next, we can begin to remove our shock. So we'll start with our bottom mount. We'll take a 21 millimeter wrench on our nut side and a 21 millimeter socket on our bolt side to pull that out. Next, we can remove the nut at the top of our shock. I've got an 18 millimeter ratcheting wrench to take that off. So now with everything disconnected that we need to disconnect, we can start lowering down our axle to be able to get our springs out. So now with our axle lowered down, we can pull our spring out. And now with our spring removed, we can pull up our top isolator. Now once we have our spring and our isolator removed from one side, we'll do that same thing on the other side. So now we're ready to install our new upper control arm. You're gonna match this up to your old one to figure out which one is for which side. And then we can slide it into our mount, get our bolts through, and get our nuts that are welded onto tabs on the insides here. And then once you have your bolts through, we can grab our nuts and thread our bolts into those. Next, we can grab our 21 millimeter socket to tighten our bolts down. So now we're ready to install our new strut. So we're gonna do the same thing, grab a buddy to pry down on the lower control arm, and I'll slide this up, slide our bottom mount into our lower control arm, and we can get our nuts up top and our bolt at the bottom. Now that we have our strut in place, we can take our new nuts and thread onto the top of our strut. Next, we can reinstall our lower strut bolt. So once again, we'll grab that pry bar and pry down on our lower control arm while we put our bolt in. Now that we have our lower strut bolt installed, we can get our nut on the other side. And then we can grab our 21 millimeter socket and our 15/16 wrench to tighten that down. So now we can reconnect our knuckle to our upper control arm. I'm gonna grab a buddy to pry down on the upper control arm to get it into the knuckle so that we can get our new nut onto the stud. Now that we have our nut threaded on by hand, we can take a 21 millimeter ratcheting wrench to tighten it down. Now we can go back up to the top of our strut and tighten down our three nuts. I've got a 15 millimeter ratcheting wrench to do so. Next, we can reinstall our tie rod end into the knuckle. And thread our nut back on. And then we'll grab our 21 millimeter socket to tighten that down. Next, we can come back to our ABS line and slide that into that S-clip. Next, we can follow our ABS line to our clip on a brake line and pop that back into place. Now, our new upper control arm doesn't have a spot to put this tree clip. And since we have a longer strut in here, we have more tension on the line. So we're just gonna leave that be. And then we'll grab our 13 millimeter bolt to thread into our brake line. And then we'll grab our 13 millimeter socket to tighten that down. Now at this point, you can do that entire process on the other side to catch up before we put our sway bar back in, because we're gonna have to drop that into our lower control arms on both sides at the same time. Now once you have your end links lined up on both sides, you can grab a pry bar to pry your sway bar down into place. And then we can reinstall that 18 millimeter nut. And we'll take our 18 millimeter socket to tighten that down. And then we'll do that same thing on the other side. So now we're ready to start assembling our rear. The first thing we're gonna do is install our spring spacer. We have this plate with a welded nut that's gonna go over the top of our spring perch. And then we'll put this on the bottom side. We have a bolt with a lock washer and a flat washer that's gonna go up through this hole and thread into that nut. So now we can grab a 14 millimeter socket for the bolt side and a 14 millimeter wrench on our nut and tighten that down. Now before we reinstall our spring, we're gonna have to cut the two nipples off of our factory isolator. That way it can sit flush against our spacer. So I have a pair of flush cutters that we'll cut these off with, and then we can get this back in the truck and install our spring. Now we can take that isolator and slide that on to our spacer. So now we can install our spring back into place. Now we have a little lip on our isolator that the end of our coil is going to rest against. So we'll get it lined up. Now once you have your springs installed on both sides, we can start to reinstall our end links. And then once we have that bolt threaded in, we'll grab a 16 millimeter socket to tighten that down. Next, we can install our new shock. We're gonna have to set up our hardware. We have our metal plate as well as a bushing with this little nub on it. And then we'll put that through our upper mount, and then we'll use our next bushing, plate, and our nut. Next, we can come to our bottom mount and slide our bolt in. Now, if your hole doesn't line up, you can raise your axle a little bit to bridge that gap. And then we'll grab our 21 millimeter socket and wrench to tighten that down. And now we can go back up top and grab a 22 millimeter wrench to tighten down our nut. Now, once you have your shock installed on one side, you can do that same thing on the other side. Now, the last thing we have to do is reconnect our track bar. So you might need to push the axle to the right side a little bit just to get your holes to line up, and then you can get your bolt through. And now with our nut threaded on the backside, we can grab our 21 millimeter socket to tighten that down. Now, before you get your wheels back on and get the truck back on the ground, make sure to install your fender liner. We've got those 4 8-millimeter screws that will thread into our clips. And then we'll grab our 8 millimeter socket to tighten these all down. And then we'll do that same thing on the other side. So that'll wrap up this review and install of the Rough Country 3.5-inch bolt-on suspension lift kit with lifted N3 struts and monotube shocks for your 2019 and newer Ram 1500 without air ride and excluding the TRX. Thank you for watching, and for all things Ram, keep it right here at AmericanTrucks.com.